Hey, babies. Baby, how you doing? Yeah.
Poor little guy.
Oh, I'm gonna bring all the kitties home. Bird is this?
Gone. That's him.
I can't believe it. My butt is in the shadow of the butt of Elvis Presley.
Oh, yes.
Okay, Elvis. We're ready to receive a great idea.
It's more than a speck. Like that. This is the tunnel. Small little tunnel in the mountain. And that's how they shot this scene.
This is our first chance to send news to you. We have made our flight to the former friends of mine.
Yes, but that water is in a very nice hole in a rock. No room, but lovely view. We can see right down into the bottom.
They're moving in herds. They do move in herds.
On this property owned by Pfluger. Pfluger family, Isenberg, Zimmerman, were the people who were responsible for bringing the Germans working for the plantation back in the 1880s. And Pfluger today in Honolulu, Pfluger Lincoln Mercury Honda car sales.
The natives on the cliffs on the right hand side. Pretty close if you don't move this railing.
As I said, like a lot of nuts joined up to a pot on the inside, so it turns yellow. That's why people think it's a pineapple tree. But everybody knows the pineapple grows on the ground, right?
Yeah.
So it sometimes gets hard to be seen. The Kaua'i vine waterfall. They love the albizia trees. Every movie we filmed on Kauai, we have the albizias. Bruce Willis sold his house here when they had the split from Debbie Moore. Sylvester Stallone has a place here. Drew Barrymore. Thank you.
Bali High there on the other side, Barry.
Way like over there, yeah.
Grab that table and order me something.
What do you want?
Anything.
Come to me, here am I.
like sewage in the water there and stuff.
I think the thrusters are just pushing up the muck. We're just slowly turning around in Na Pali harbor. Look, see that mountain is now covered in clouds? Wettest places on earth.
Yeah.
What do you say, 600 inches of rain a year?
Or? It was like 450 or something like that.
He said
the year of the last hurricane, it got over 670.
Yeah.
Something 650.
And this hotel right here, that's where Steven Spielberg stayed when they were making Jurassic Park. So part of it is filmed out of the window of his hotel when the hurricane hit.
Those big waves and stuff you see are from that hurricane.
That's the biggest or the tallest resort in Kauai.
What other famous movie site did we see? Bali.
Yeah, we saw Bali High in South Pacific. But I didn't get a chance to wash the man right out of my hair.
Sorry, I'm still here.
You're still here. Does that mean I'm as corny as Kansas in August? The great part about this port is we didn't have to tender, but it was close enough to town that we could just walk in. Plus, they had a free shuttle. Solar panels and no air conditioning, and they just kind of live off the land as much as possible. So those people came out to watch us leave?
I suppose.
Look at that double canoe. See that?
What
is that?
You talking about that thing?
Yeah.
Like I don't know what that is. But not a catamaran.
It's like a catamaran, yeah, but it looks like a double canoe for some reason.
If I lived near cruise ships, I'd watch them leave once in a while.
Yeah.
Just fun to do.
Are those all the people that are supposed to be on the ship and didn't make it?
Yeah, probably.
Wave goodbye.
I think they'd be more infuriated.
These jetties, I think, they filmed the water splashing up on in Jurassic Park during the Hurricane Aniki. Yeah. I did like the North Shore of Hawaii better than the South Side. Hawaii. Thank you.
This is China, your Hawaiian ambassador, speaking to you from the bridge. Now at this time, we're beginning our journey along the spectacular Na Pali coastline of Kauai's beautiful north shore. So if I may draw your attention to the port on the left-hand side of the vessel for a brief narrative of what you're about to see. Now for those of you that do have a stateroom on the port on the left-hand side of the vessel when facing forward, you can tune into channel 23, and there you'll be able to hear my narration at that time. Now we're just getting ready. We're, as you can see, our officers are just turning the ship, so we're going to be broadside, so we can make our way to get a nice, clear view of this beautiful northern coastline. I do hope you have those cameras ready. Now this is our whale season. We haven't had any sightings just yet. But always keep your eyes open because they're definitely in town and they could pop up at any time. Keep your eyes focused as well in the downs because we do have the occasional waterfall that could be coming down and be for all of you as well. This is the wettest island with 400 to 600 inches of rain per year, which you can how green and lush it looks as well. You know, as we kind of continue to move further down, I'm just going to really quickly go through and recap your visit here with the Hawaiian Islands. As we started off in Honolulu and we set sail to the island of Maui. As we made our way into Kapolui Sunday morning, we had two wonderful days to enjoy the island of Maui at 727 square miles. It's also known as the island, and I'm sure you would agree with all the beautiful mountain ranges that you were surrounded by. Beautiful place to enjoy so many things to do and see. Having those 2 days, I'm sure you had the opportunity to do so many different things. Either maybe taking that long drive to Hana, that winding road that switches back and forth, going through the eucalyptus drive, seeing some of the falls, the Twin Falls, Waimoku Falls, the red and black sand beach, you know, wonderful places to stop and take some great photos, looking at the caves, and so many wonderful things to capture. Stands a little over 10,000 feet above sea level. And I'm sure you experienced that chill in the air as you made your way to the top. The dust dropped to about 20 degrees, and I get quite chilly up there, but my gosh, the spectacular terrain as well as the colors that it displays. Those beautiful morning sunrises, and of course, the wonderful sunsets to enjoy as well. The south side, a lot of great places to enjoy, the Grand White Bay, Kena Beach, along with a lot of great places to do some snorkeling, you know, wonderful golf courses we have on the island also, Hulapalakua, one of our wineries, we have the lavender farm, the goat farm, a lot of great things to enjoy on the southern point of the island of Maui. You know, one of my favorite places to enjoy is on the west side. Which is a small window. Here you can go ahead and walk through town and enjoy all the shops, antiques, boutiques as well, galleries, art museums, as well as the Marion Tree that was right there in town on Front Street that takes up one full city block. This is where a lot of our local Kauai'i or family that come from the neighbor islands of Lanai and Molokai to display all of their beautiful artwork as well as crafts. But that evening, on Monday, it was time to leave. And we headed out to the big island. And unfortunately, we had to do a little detour because of weather. But on Wednesday, Captain Mahenga made his way to Kailua Corner, where it was a beautiful sunny day. I do hope you had the opportunity to go ashore and enjoy the wonderful shops, places to eat. Maybe south of the island, and much, much more. Home to our coffee trees as well. Over 150 coffee trees, plantations on the Big Island. The Big Island is 3,028 square miles. Now think about this, it's the largest island. If we were to combine all the other islands into the Big Island, it would still be twice as large. It is the least populated island per square mile.
Yeah, I know. It's like mine.
That evening, we left and we pulled in to the Milifini Harbor on Thursday morning. And what a great, perfect day to start off with the sun shining, the beautiful sunrise.
Is that a moon? Oh, yeah.
A lot of big things to enjoy. We could swim down at Kalapaki Beach, or maybe take a ride to the from Mark Twain to the Grand Canyon of the Pacific. Kekaha, we have also Poipu Beach, making our way to the northern side of the island. The Fern Grotto, this is where Elvis Presley, one of his increases, was taken for Bill Hawaii, the wedding scene. Or maybe he had the opportunity to take that kayak ride a little further up to swim under the falls. Continuing around the northern point, Princeville, as well as Hanalei Bay, which is a very popular site for all to go ahead and enjoy a nice afternoon swim. And this is where Mitzi Gaynor actually washed all that in right on over here. So we do hope that you have a wonderful opportunity to enjoy so many sights on all of the islands that we visited. But here we are, on the island of Kauai, which is nicknamed the Garden Island, and is the fourth largest in size of the eight major islands, and was once formed by a massive shield volcano named Orokele. The second highest peak is named Vai Aleale, standing at a height of nearly 5,148 feet. Vai Aleale is noted to be the wettest spot in the world, with an average rainfall of 450 to 500 inches of rain in a year. Kauai is nearly circular in shape and encompasses 533 square miles, 25 miles long and 33 miles wide at its furthest point. Only 3% of the island has been developed for commercial and residential use, leaving the remaining 97% divided between agriculture and conservation. Now, as we sail closer to the Na Pali coastline, we're going to take you further back in time. So just imagine millions of years ago and 2,000 miles away from any other landmass, a battle between Earth's molten core, fire and water from rain, to what we know today as the beautiful Hawaii.
You can see how the gouge is down there.
The sun is coming out tonight.
Beautiful.
Spectacular colors. It changes every week. We have days when it's a bit of calm coming. It doesn't mean it's going to take the beauty away on this beautiful coastline. It's just that the colors, the sun can definitely change the depth of the valleys as well. So enjoy this beautiful day. As you can see, we're navigating past the northern shores of the island of Kauai. These shores are better known throughout the world as the Na Pali Coast State Park, named for the majestic cliffs or pali that define the area. This area encompasses over 6,175 acres. This 50-mile stretch of coastline is one of the least disturbed wildlands in Hawaii. The spectacular views of the rugged scenery makes a vivid impression on visitors. Yet when volcanic activity on Kauai's northwestern coastline ended 6 million years ago, there were no cliffs on the coast at all. Instead, the entire island of Kauai was dome-shaped, and the coast extended into a gradual slope a mile farther out to sea than it does at present.
To ride away.
10 million years of volcanic eruptions built the Hawaiian Islands to their latest height. The Na Pali coast is the result of a 6 million-year contest between solid lava rock and persistent erosion. Kauai's thundering winter surf and torrential rain have etched their marks in the northwestern corner of the original shield
wall,
laying bare the green lava barrels and dikes you see today. Now, some of the cliffs are straight up at about 4,000 feet above sea level. At this distance, they do look like they are jagged and sharp, but up close, you will see they are more the soft and smooth side. If you look close enough, you might even see the wildlife on the streets, including the long white-tailed birds, mountain goats, and even the white-tailed deer. Historians believe this rugged yet beautiful coastline was the first area of Kauai to be settled by the ancient Hawaiians. As inhospitable as this place is, they provided
something up there.
All of the beach. Fresh water from the mountain stream, native vegetation, fertile ground in the valleys, and unparalleled fishing of the vast ocean. These sea cliffs begin at Kilauea and continue around the north and west portion of Kauai for about 15 miles and at Polihana Beach. Now, before we make the turn onto the Na Pali coast, we passed Hyena Point. This point was where Laka, the Hula goddess, first bestowed the gift of Hula to mortals on a humble-looking rock platform that was the most important Hula school in all of Hawaii. This sacred area is named Kaulu'apa'oa Hilea. Young men and women came here for months of rigorous training in the strict religious atmosphere to learn dances that recount the legends and invoke favors from the gods. Hawaiian legend tells us that the hands of Chief Loki all dance here before the spirit form of the fiery goddess Pele, inciting the passion that gave this area its name. Haena, meaning the heat. Today, Haena Point is still honored as hula dancers continue to sing and chant on this
beautiful
trail.
Yes, thank you.
In Haena State Park, the roads around the island end and the trail begins. The Pali coast can only be accessed by air, sea, or foot.
Thank you.
Now, Ke'e Beach marks the beginning of the Kalalau Trail, or the 14-mile trail that will take you into one of the beautiful valleys of the Na Pali coastline. It is a rugged trail that is not for the faint of heart, but the views you get are absolutely worth it. Now looking into the mountains above Kaua'i Beach, those of you who are fans of musicals will recognize the Twin Peaks of Mount Kai that would be famous in the musical South Pacific. So if you look towards the stern, of course the back of the ship,
oh, yeah,
you can see the Twin Peaks.
Flipping.
As we continue to cruise along the coastline, many of you will recognize several places that Hollywood has promoted through movies, and I will point out a few spots along the way.
Good,
2 miles down from Kaua'i Beach, we encounter our first valley, Hanakapea. Here, you find a sand beach in the summer that erodes to a boulder beach in the winter, because of the strong winter sun.
It's definitely a long walk for me.
It's beautiful.
Our next valley is via Huakua. Rainfall runoffs whittle down the lava slopes at the same time that the surf cuts away their seaward edges. As a result, these valleys have floors that sit well above sea level and are so called hanging valleys. Archaeological remains indicate that Hanako once cradled a sizable Hawaiian farming community. 50 Hawaiians lived in this valley in 1835. But by the 1800s, they had abandoned taro and modified the terraces for growing coffee trees.
Yeah, that one's good.
Now,
yeah,
we are
moving very slowly, I think, because we were in front of that
here on the Napali coast. So I'm going to share with you some. Approximately 10 to 15 minutes. We'll be bringing it down on the starboard side of the ship for a few minutes for you to continue to enjoy the view. The colors do change, so let me tell you, when they do make their turn, continue to enjoy the view, and you'll definitely see some changes in the color as we continue on down. But as we do make that turn, in the distance, you will see another island from the ship. It is the island of Niihau and its neighbor island, Nehua. Niihau is nicknamed the Forbidden Island. The island comprises 72 square miles and is approximately 18 miles long and 8 miles across at its widest point. Niihau is the only privately owned island in the state. The major transfer of Niihau's land ownership.
There's already different colors in it compared to the other one.
When the Sinclair family purchased the island with the government to Hawaiian minister of
the Pacific Islands. See, now if you went on a cruise, you would not say that.
For more than a century, the
Oh, I am. Tremendously, yes. Yeah.
Most information about the people and their life has been gathered from the Inhal residents themselves. The people of the Inhal are hardworking and well-taken care of. The majority of the residents are of Hawaiian ancestry, comprising the largest colony of pure Hawaiians in the state. Idleness is rare, and free time is spent sharing life with friends and family. They do live off the produce of the land, relying only on the leaves for water. And all the people here speak English. But since Hawaiian is their first name, they often prefer to speak the language of their forefathers. The men of Kauai make the most bizarre charcoal in the state of the world of the Kauai tree. And the women are admired for the beautiful that they so intricately designed into leaves from shells only found
on the birds in there.
It takes many months or years to collect, sort, grade, and string these tiny shells into the most sought after shell jewelry. Prices for these rare collectibles can reach into the thousands of dollars. The Ni'iha shell is the only shell in the world that can be insured for up to $5,000. So settle into their island homes with new changes. Ni'ihawans are happy and healthy, and they are rarely motivated to gain more material possessions beyond their basic needs. They have no worries about paying the mortgage on time because their homes are provided by the Robinson family. Like previous members of their family, the Robinsons continue to protect the economy from disruptive modern influence, and in so doing, help to perpetuate the traditional Hawaiian way of life. We are just the boss.
Are we time traveling?
Share more information of the largest valley here in the island, here in the point, which is Kauai.
I don't think they even make film anymore, do they?
Not as readily available.
They don't make Kodachrome anymore.
No. I finally took Paul Simon's Kodachrome away.
Mm-hmm. Well, that is pretty.
But the last inhabitants left in 1919. This small community had a school and a church that missionaries established in the 1800s. And while the Hawaiians of Kalala lived in peely grass houses, made blankets from the kapa bark, and used traditional implements made of stone, they were already wearing European clothes made of cloth. While they still used wooden canoes with sails to trade their taro with the people of Niihau, Hanalei, and Waimea, foreign money was now the medium of exchange. Once the missionaries came to Kalawao, they westernized the people and encouraged them to move away from their isolated valley to the more populated areas of Hanalei and Waimea. By 1919, Kalawao Valley was no longer a missionary. Today, visitors to the valley are able to see the remarkable remains of the once thriving fishing village.
She needs you. He didn't pay that steam.
You or me?
He's so nice.
As
he tell me to come in. He saw me, I'm sure.
Next valley would be Honopu.
So pretty.
And Honopu offers one of the most enchanting settings along the coast. Two wide sand beaches divided by a dramatic arch and flanked by a small waterfall. And above, the valley walls rise in a stunning array of night sight.
Yes.
Honopu was also a sacred meeting place for the elite. Or the royal city. It has a burial ground hidden in the cave and the pit of the valley. Honopu translates to clam-shell beautiful valley. This isolated valley is a very popular site for Hollywood movies. Some of the movies that were filmed here that you visited are
the light hitting it in that direction, it's really pretty.
The openings of Jurassic Park 1 and 2. Jessica Lange was also bathing in the falls of Honopu for her 1973 remake of King Kong. Movie makers and filmmakers truly enjoy coming to this island. There's been so many wonderful films that have been produced here in the island. View Hawai'i, as included in the Billy Billy Park staff, we had the scene of man with the helicopter that would come on down.
Is that a face?
Yeah, it looks like a face.
It's a face.
Yeah.
Into the rock.
Oh, yeah.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
I'm saying that it is.
Lost, Hawaii Bible, and much, much more. The Descent is another one. Not to forget that. Well, as we continue on down, and get to enjoy all those wonderful sights, our next guys will include the Puhia Nu'alolo, Nu'alolo Aina, and Nu'alolo Kauai. Nu'alolo Valley was one of the longest inhabited of all the valleys on the Na Pali coast due to its abundance of fresh fish. There was a fishing village of about 300 people living by the coast until the 1940s. Today, only the well-preserved Princeville has been replaced.
Oh, yeah.
A heavily terraced valley on the plateau of Lost Ark for miles from the shore. Nu'alolo Kauai is also home to turtles, the Hawaiian court, where giant green sea turtles that find refuge in this reef.
She's got to have somebody to talk to.
Score one for Dwayne.
Yeah. All the way you can do it.